Hey, cranky heads, welcome back to the laboratory. Dr. Cranky here on a gorgeous Sunday morning. And I wanted to talk a little bit about art. I know it sounds like a lofty thing to talk about, but I've had it in my life since I was 12. I went to school thinking that I would become an artist one day, and I just ended up doing something else completely. Different, still an artistic endeavor. I mean, I write, but art's always been my passion. So I wanted to show you what else goes on in the laboratory while I build models. So it's a very healthy relationship between building models and then doing my art, or what I call my art. So I'll just show you a few pieces that I work on. I normally do maybe two or three of these a year, and it's been wonderful. I think it's helped me become a much better model builder, because you know, you keep all your skills practiced. It's like playing an instrument, which you already know I can't play, but you do learn to stay in touch with that creative part of yourself that's going to keep it fun. Otherwise, why do it, right? But anyway, let me show you some pieces that I've been working on in the last few years. I usually collect a lot of crap. I mean, stuff that people throw out, flea markets, stuff on off of eBay that I often get in huge lots, like, for example, old TV and radio light bulbs, things like that. Or tubes, they're not called light bulbs, you'll see in a minute. But it's all fun, except of course, you know, I end up hoarding all this stuff, but you know, I keep it all localized to one place, so it's not a big deal. But it's, you know, a lot of what people would consider to be trash, I think it's a treasure. So and I love it. So I'm going to show you a few pieces here. I haven't painted them. It's a very slow process to paint them. You know, it's stuff like this that you look at, and of course you say, well, he's lost his mind, and it is a kind of a madness, but, you know, they're made out of cigar boxes and then a lot of junk that I find. Of course, this is called, if I could be funny for 1 minute, this is called bad milk, which is why the cow is a two-headed cow, right? And there's some sort of dentist syringe thingy up here, and it's, you know. So a lot of toys go into this, a lot of junk. I like it because it makes me create stuff out of trash, and why not? And that's how I give a little bit back to the world, thinking I'm recycling a lot, like, you know, beer caps, all of that great stuff. This is a little piece I did last year that I still have to paint. It's almost done. But, you know, I think you've seen this before. So a lot of it is steampunk / crankified madness, as I call it. So just, and yeah, you know, that works, right? You turn it and then the baby gives you more hugs, right? Just pure madness, but I like doing stuff like that. And this piece I did 2 days ago because it came to me in a dream, okay? And it's so heavy because it's a baby's plastic head, chopped at the top and then filled with, dentist grade plaster. So it weighs a ton. But as you can see, it's just one of these, my daughters call them, my spooky babies, you know, and, so I still have to paint it and I have to finish it. But I just wanted to show you, we're doing more than just building models. I also do mixed media art, painting, with all sorts of, you know, media. So, you know, you could see this is done with photographs and plexiglass and wood and metal and anything else I can get my hands on. A few of you have asked how I end up having so much paint and stuff. Well, that's the reason. You know, a model doesn't take that much paint to do, but to do art, it's just constant. And being young, I remember that was one of the factors that kept me out of doing more art. I mean, the supplies get to be really, 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 really expensive. and it gets to be crazy. So, but now that I'm older, you know, I've amassed enough junk and enough supplies to be able to last me quite a while. So I just wanted to show it to you, share it with you, just in case you were wondering, you know, he just spends all his time doing models, and no, I build models, and then I build a little bit of crazy art, and that's it. And then I write for a living, so that's, you know, it keeps me plenty busy. So anyway, hope you enjoyed it, and tune back in. You never know what's going to come out of the laboratory, all right? And Igor says hi.